Hello and a warm welcome to our program. You're watching One TV News Bulletin in English at 5. I'm Yanni Mutsios. These are today's top stories. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky denounces divisions inside the European Union over more sanctions against Russia, asks why some EU member states were allowed to block the plan. Russian President Vladimir Putin and Italy's Prime Minister Mario Draghi discussed ways to help ease the international food crisis. We shall defend Greece and its sovereignty, Mitsotakis stresses in his first in-person cabinet meeting. Fire Brigade attended an explosion incident in downtown Athens, one person severely injured. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky on Thursday denounced divisions inside the European Union over more sanctions against Russia and asked why some nations were not being allowed to block the plan. The EU is discussing a sixth round of punitive measures, including an embargo on Russian oil imports. Such a move requires unanimity, but Hungary opposes the idea for now on the grounds its economy would suffer too much. Zelensky, in a late-night address, noted that Russia was receiving €1 billion a day from the 27-nation block for energy supplies. Berlin hopes talks on the new round of sanctions will be completed soon, but it will not be a topic at the leaders' summit next week, a German official said on Wednesday. Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orban also said the issue would not be discussed at the summit. Zelensky's comments mark the second day in a row that he has sharpened his criticism of the world's approach to the war. On Wednesday, he lambasted suggestions that Kyiv make concessions to bring peace, saying the idea smacked of attempts to appease Nazi Germany in 1938. He also reiterated complaints that the world has so far failed to totally isolate the Russian banking system and was not providing heavy weapons quickly enough. Ukraine's Foreign Minister Dmytro Kuleba said Wednesday his country badly needed multiple launch rocket systems to match Russian firepower. According to experts, the United States is hesitant to provide more such weapon systems, which fire missiles at a distance of 80 kilometers and could hit Russian territory, including Russian missile sites in Crimea. Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov warned that any supplies of weapons that could reach Russian territory would be a serious step towards unacceptable escalation. EU leaders will discuss Ukraine, defense, food and energy security at a special summit on 30 and 31st of May. Coming up next, we shall defend Greece and its sovereignty, Mitsotakis stresses in his first in-person cabinet meeting. Russian President Vladimir Putin and Italy's Prime Minister Mario Draghi on Thursday discussed ways to help ease the international food crisis, with the Kremlin saying this could be done only if the West lifts sanctions. Vladimir Putin emphasized that the Russian Federation is ready to make a significant contribution to overcoming the food crisis through the export of grain and fertilizers, provided that politically motivated restrictions from the West are lifted, Moscow said in a statement. Ukraine's Black Sea ports have been blocked since Russia sent thousands of troops into Ukraine on February 24th, and more than 20 million tons of grains are stuck in silos in the country. Russia and Ukraine account for nearly a third of global wheat supplies, and the lack of significant grain exports from Ukraine ports is contributing to a growing global food crisis. Regarding the risk of a world food crisis, the Kremlin statement blames disruptions in the operation of production and logistics chains, as well as the financial policies of Western countries during the coronavirus pandemic, the situation being aggravated due to anti-Russian restrictions imposed by the United States and the European Union. The Kremlin appears to confirm that Italy will continue to receive Russian gas. Prime Minister Kyriakos Mitsotakis kicked off a meeting of the cabinet on Friday with a new message concerning the rising tension in relations between Greece and Turkey, addressing the first in-person meeting of the full cabinet held since February 2020. The meeting follows the Prime Minister's highly significant trip to the United States and his attendance of the World Economic Forum in Davos, Switzerland, which he said had sent a message that Greece is strong on a diplomatic, defense, and energy level. It is precisely this message that President Biden, the Vice President of the American Congress uploaded and was agreed with soon afterwards in Switzerland by the President of the European Central Bank, the Director of the International Monetary Fund, but also global business giants that now see Greece as a dynamic destination for investments, Mitsotakis added. However, the Prime Minister stressed that not everyone welcomes stronger Greece, so that it was now being subjected to displays of bravado on the part of its neighbors. The more they threaten us, though, the more they expose themselves, and I believe that for as long as they provoke us, they become marginalized. We have said many times that geography wants us to be side by side, but they choose to stand against us, against international law, Europe and NATO, he added. We therefore have no reason to begin dialogue with what is absurd, the historically unfounded, and finally, leads nowhere. On the contrary, we always remain open to every approach that is based on international legality and good neighbor relations. This does not mean, however, that we will not defend our rights or that we will not raise the unacceptable things that have been happening in our region over the recent months in all the international fora, Mitsotakis stressed. Now, more to come. Fire Brigade attended an explosion incident in downtown Athens. One person severely injured. American businessman and founder of Microsoft, Bill Gates, will be visiting Athens today following an invitation by the CEO of Pfizer, Albert Bourla. Bill Gates is expected to arrive in Athens today, and he will reside in the presidential suite of the Grand Britannia Hotel. Gates had previously visited Athens in 2008 to cut the opening ribbon of the Microsoft Innovation Center. Bill Gates is expected to travel to the Greek islands in the following days. Now, a fire brigade received a call to attend an incident regarding a blast downtown Athens early today in a mini market shop. Firefighters who attended the incident arrived at the spot, though the fire has already been put out. A man bearing severe burns was taken to hospital for further examination and for first aid provision. According to information from bystanders, the fire brigade is investigating causes of the blast, which is likely to be attributed to a gas leak. Police asked the neighbors and the shops to evacuate the area as a precaution. Three persons were arrested last night on the incidents of the place outside the Aristotelium University of Thessaloniki and have been taken before the first-degree court, where they would be tried today. The three defendants have been charged with disturbance of public peace, insubordination, attempted physical harm, criminal mischief, carrying weapons, violation of the law regarding rallies, and drugs. Anarchist members have mustered outside the court mansion of Thessaloniki in support of the three defendants. Police forces cordon the court in order to prevent any riot incidents from taking place. That's all from us for now. Stay with us next news bulletin in Greek at 6 o'clock. Thank you for watching.